welcome to Herstory. Today on the show, we have a bona fide Indiana Jones-esque paleoanthropologist and archaeologist, Mary Leakey. Cheers. To help our viewers visualize what you did, I have a little model here of one of your greatest discoveries, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, dear God.
I don't have much meat on my bones.
Had nothing to do with dinosaurs.
Beg pardon?
Monkey, chimpanzee, hominid,
but you're
proconsul skull,
but you're
dinosaur.
Sounds like you really specialized in monkey business.
And the puns continue.
Tell me a little bit about your childhood, because from what I understand, you were a bit of a firecracker.
As a child, I traveled around Europe quite a bit with my parents. Then my father tragically died at a young age, and I was devastated. My mother felt like she needed to raise me in a proper way, so we moved to London. I was expelled from not one but two Catholic schools. By this point, I knew I had an interest in science, anthropology, archaeology. I set out in doing my own independent studies in these areas and started auditing classes at university. Pretty soon, became quite proficient in flint prints and scientific illustration.
There's a date that I'd like to toss out at you that is not so savory. 1933, the year you met a man married at the time, named Lewis Leakey. Hence the name that is last of yours.
1933, I was 20 years old, and I was invited to a dinner party where I was introduced to a prominent archaeologist at the time named Lewis Leakey. He was in search of a scientific illustrator for a book he was working on.
Quick question, Mary Leakey, what was inside of Frieda Leakey's belly when you met her husband?
Frieda was pregnant. Put her out of commission, it was all awful pregnancy. She couldn't illustrate, and so Lewis said, oh, hello, young thing, why don't you illustrate for me? We fell in love, all right.
Tell you what, pick up your passport and let's hop away from that scandal in Britain to Olduvai Gorge in Africa, where you really spent a bulk of your career.
1948, for instance, was quite an exciting year for me. That's when I discovered the skull, Proconsul Africanus. It is now thought to have belonged to a human ancestor. 1959 was an incredible breakout year. It made Leakey a household name, really, after the discovery that I led of the Australopithecus boy's eye specimen, which was 1.75 million years old. It completely revolutionized the time scale of human evolution.
The high point, I would say, of your career, at least that's what you said in your autobiography, and here's a hint, footprint!
You're referring clearly to the Laetoli footprints. This was a discovery I made in the late 70s. Almost perfectly preserved, 89-foot long trail of early hominid footprints, 3.6 million years old. And when I made that discovery, the earliest human ancestor footprints that were known were only tens of thousands of years old. That far back, our hominid ancestors were already demonstrating bipedal locomotion. They were walking around on 2 feet.
By this point, Mary Leakey, you and your husband, Lewis, have had a son, Richard, and you really become known as the first family of paleontology.
Little Richie, 6 years old, runs up to me, so excited because he has discovered the bone of an extinct species of pig. I knew he had it in his bones. There's a pun for you.
But one little addendum to this happily ever after is that your relationship with your husband was a little bit strained professionally.
By the late 60s and 70s, Lewis was off doing his own thing, cavorting around, professionally speaking, with Jane Goodall and others. I was a much more methodical researcher than he was, and I was able to spot flaws in some of his classifications of fossils. I spoke publicly about them.
You continued active field work until the age of 70, after which point you continued to be an evangelist for archaeology and paleoanthropology. Your family members continue on in the tradition as well. You were recently honored with your own Google Doodle to celebrate your 100th birthday, and on top of that, the Royal Mail in the UK selected you, yes you, as one of the 6 Great Britons who got a commemorative stamp! Mary Leakey, when thousands of strangers are licking the back of your head, you know you've arrived in the halls of Herstory.
More people, especially little girls and young women, need to be more exposed to these sorts of works. Even today, archaeology is still quite dominated by men. I only wish I could encourage even more women.
Thank you for coming on the show, and if I ever get married, you are not coming over to dinner.